In today's video, we will learn what is seed migrations in Hasura. Hello guys, my name is Mitch Romzhensky. I just realized that I have not been publishing videos about Hasura for a while, and in this video I try to correct myself, and today we will talk about seed migrations in Hasura. So what is the seed migrations? If you remember, regular migrations, they allow you to restore the database schema when you start your Hasura project from the scratch. And seed migrations work similar, but it allows you to fill out the tables with predefined data. So when it could be useful? Well, let's imagine that we have tasks, and these tasks has some different state, like in progress, done, and so on and so on. And you know that three steps to do, doing, and done are always kind of predefined. It's default values, and you need them always. It means that if you don't use these seed migrations, you have to create these three types of tasks always manually. But we can write a SQL script or like seed migration, which allows us to predefine this immediately when we start the project from the scratch. And let's have a look how it looks in real project. Okay, let's get started. So here is our application from previous videos about Hasura, and what we implemented here, it's just a simple to-do list, so you can insert the list, and we also have some basic authentication. And in today's video, I would like also to add some statuses to our tasks. So something like to do, doing, or done, these three statuses. And I want to display them somewhere in the right top corner or somewhere below. That doesn't matter really. But we have to display this status. And besides this, we want to create a seed migration which will insert this three statuses immediately once we start the Hasura Docker container. So first of all, let's go to terminal and run our Hasura console in order to automatically generate migrations for us. Then I have to go to data and we'll create a new table. I will call this table task status. And here will be the ID column, and it will be, let it be integer, auto increment. I don't really care, integer also fine. And will be name, and there will be text. Then we have to say that ID is primary key, and then we can add table. All right, so our task status table was created, and now inside the task, I have to add the new field, which will be status ID, and it will be integer. Let's save it. So we see that status ID was successfully created. We have to add also the new foreign key. I will pick our task status table, and I will say that status ID, it's reference to ID from the table task status. And I will click save. Now we should be able to go to relationships and create the relation. This one, suggested object relation, and I will name it like task status. And the last step would be to go to the task statuses and insert some rows like to do, then in progress, and the last one is done. So here we go. We inserted all these three statuses. And now, in theory, we should be able to fetch these tasks.
with also statuses. So I will pick title, then ID and name. And if we run this, okay, task status null, because we have to say that this has status ID 1 and save it. And most probably we have to modify this and set some default value that by default it will be it will have to-do status. So let's save it. Then we go to GraphQL, and if I run, yeah, we see task status, name, to-do. So I will copy this new part of the query, and we have to adjust also our Angular app. If I go to app query, here is our tasks, and here before users, I will add this part of the query. And now we have to rerun our types generator. If you have been following my videos, you know what is auto type generator. If not, you can find this video on my channel. I also add the link to this video in this video description, so you can have a look at this later. But for now, what we have to do is to run one npm script called generate types. So let's do it right now. This script will regenerate the services which we are using to call this GraphQL endpoint, and it will allow our application to work properly then. And the next step, we have to show our status somewhere below. What's wrong? Okay, it says that there is no task status. Okay, I think it's something with permissions. Let's have a look. Let's go to tasks, permissions. User can select, right, that we have to save, and also in task status, in permissions, we also need to tell Hasura that user without any checks can select these values, right, and can select also ID and name. Now we save permission, and if we try to reload, we should see our task. Yeah, here we go, we see our task. So I will close the console, and now somewhere below I want to place the label that this task in to-do state or status or in progress or it is done. So let's do it right now. I go to VS Code, then let's find our dashboard to-do list, and where we will place it. Here is our mudcart content, and here below I would say we will add the div, and here we will say that task dot task status dot name. So if we save it and reload our application, we see there is our to-do status rendered here, which is fine. And now we have to create a seed migration. And why do we need it? Let's do the next. Let's stop our Hasura container and remove completely our DB data. So I just drop our databases, and then I have to stop, of course, my Docker containers. So here we go, I stop it. And now if we restart our Docker containers again, we will see that all data will be removed, but the database schema will be there because we have the migrations for this. Let's check this out. So here I have to log out because I believe everything, also user profiles, everything will be removed. So we have to create a new user. I will create this with a Google. So I have created a new account and let's try to add the new task. So there will be test, and I will open my debugger as well because I know that there will be error. And if we submit this, we see that GraphQL error foreign key violation. Insert or update on table task violates foreign key constraint task status ID foreign key. And it makes sense because when we try to insert, oops, I have to start Hasura console again. Okay, now it's better. And if we go to the data and we see that we try to insert the task, which has by default this status one, default status one, but when it tries to map with these task statuses, it sees there is no such a value, such a status with ID 1. And that's why we get this exception. So if we want to fix this issue, we have to manually insert row and say that to do save. And now we have our to do with ID 1, and if we try to submit this right now, we will see that it's working fine. But do you agree that it's quite annoying to add manually always these statuses, and we also have to add the additionally two, yeah, to in progress and done. And there is a better way how we can achieve this. And if we go to SQL section here inside the data tab, we can write the SQL script which can insert some certain values for us. And this script would look like this. So it just pure SQL, and it says that insert in our task status table inside field ID and name the next values, ID 1 with the text to do, ID 2 with text in progress, and so on. But before we write the script, we have to remove this current record, because otherwise there will be conflict that we try insert the value which already exists. And what's wrong? All right, we probably have some task which has reference to this field. Yeah, that's this task we have to also remove. And now we have no reference to our task status and exactly this ID, so we can also remove it. And now let's go back to SQL and run the script. And before to run, we should mark this as a migration, so we have to save it as migration in order to apply it later. So I will just give some name to this migration. I will name it my first seed migration. Here we go. Now I can run it, and this SQL will be executed. And if we go to task status, we see that it was inserted. And beside this, if we go to our project, we also see our my first seed migration which was created, and there inside we see our script which we executed in our Hasura console. All right, and now let's do just final test. We will stop all our consoles, Docker containers, and also we will drop our current database. Okay, and then we will log out from our application. Then I will restart my Docker containers. All right, sometimes you can come across the issue that your Hasura starts before the Postgres has been initialized, so you can get an error. In this case, you just have to restart the Hasura container and it will fix the issue. Here we go, our Hasura was restarted, and let's go to our application, create a new user. I will create login user one more time. Great, there is my new account, and I will fill it out. Description will be test, and now if I submit, everything is working fine because we applied successfully seed migrations. And if we run Hasura console and then go to the data task status, you see that all three statuses are there and it was executed by our seed migration, which we created in this video. Okay, guys, that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and the information here was useful for you and you will be applying this for your Hasura projects. Of course, I will proceed to publish new videos about Hasura and also about Angular. So this is the right time to subscribe to my channel if you didn't do this yet. I always waiting for your feedback in comment section. And I would say that's it. Thank you for your attention. Have a productive week and see you in the future.